So what's it been like trying to pick yourselves up from last week?
Yeah, it's always difficult, I think, when you've come from a defeat like that. But I think the two previous games, we kind of got away with it a bit, getting results. More so the Hibs game. I know we put a bit of pressure on them second half, but we probably should have been dead and buried that game. We get a draw, and then the home game at St Johnson wasn't the best. So, and then we lose on Saturday, so it shouldn't have been a surprise because we hadn't been at it for a few weeks, so we can only got ourselves to blame. And we've got a massive game, as I said, on Saturday, a game that both teams will want to pick up 3 points.
It's a couple of games now without a win, whereas before you were on quite a positive run. How important is it to get that consistency?
It's massive. That's the one thing we built over the last few years. I don't think we went 2 or 3 games, or we've lost 2 or 3 in a row. I think them days were gone when we always bounce back well from a bad result. So that's the only way you can do it. I think you got to let your feet do the talking. You got to pick up points, because you can harp on about everything and you can speak till you're blue in the face about what you didn't do and what you should have done. But the only way you can put that right is out on the pitch. And come Saturday, I think both teams will want to try win, but I think we need the 3 points. We need to get as many points on the board before the break.
Do you get frustrated, or is it quite easy just to sort of put it behind you and
focus on
the next one?
Personally, no. I'm a nightmare, to be honest with you. It's the same with a few of the lads in there. It's quite hard to let stuff go, and sleeping after a game, especially a midweek game, yeah. Brain's running 100 mile an hour, your body's knackered, but your head just won't let you sleep. You won't forget stuff. You go through every pass, you remember everything you've done in a game. So it is hard to brush it and just let it go, but as I said, you can't affect that now. I think as you get older, you do realise that you can't affect what's gone on before, and you have to think positive. You have to think in the next game. And I think as a group, we are quite good at that. We've got a lot of experience in there. I think the experienced players have done well to spin it around, I think, and help the younger boys from the disappointment in Europe, and how we built their season back after that, because I think everybody was waiting for us to trip up again.
What's it like playing at this time of year? Obviously quite busy, close to Christmas.
Yeah, it's good and bad, to be honest with you. It's good for the punters that use are coming to the game, but as players, it's always difficult if you don't get many days off in December. You've got games constantly. So it is good getting games and all of that, but you wouldn't know it's Christmas in the dressing room, put it that way. There's no one dancing around in the Santa outfit yet, but it's part and parcel of the job. We're used to it. So you just got to get on with it. We've got other things that we get benefits from and other people don't, so you can't moan about it too much, to be honest.
What are you expecting from Ross County?
I think the same as what we got here when we played them. We drew in it all. I think it'll be a tough game. They've picked up a bit of form lately. They went through a little bit of a blip, kind of like we've gone through, so I think it's going to be a competitive game, like you're always going to get in this league. There's no easy games, no matter whether you're playing top or bottom. But we've got to do what we're good at, and if we can get back to doing that, I'm sure we'll pick up 3 points.
Will a big turnout help performance?
Yeah, as I said, the away fans have been brilliant since I've been at the club, and the lads really appreciate it. People spending their money, especially at this time of the year, and everyone's got a lot of stuff to be spending money on and presents to be buying, and you do appreciate it because you know how expensive it is to go to football games now, especially if you've got families, as I said, if you're bringing 2 or 3 people. So we appreciate that, even more so the home fans as well, just as much, and hopefully we can get a good performance on Saturday and 3 points.
Thank you.